Welcome to this Bend the Curve webcast. Bend the Curve is an educational campaign developed by NEHI with support from the WellPoint Foundation, aimed at providing healthcare leaders with actionable ways to reduce spending without impacting quality in an effort to create high-value healthcare. The campaign covers seven critical areas of wasteful healthcare spending and seeks to provide healthcare professionals with data to identify where costs can be reduced and recommendations for actionable solutions. In this webcast, we'll be looking at the problem of vaccine underuse. Targeting the $53 billion spent annually on vaccine underuse requires building on proven practices and implementing policy actions to target the root causes of the problem. These include innovations in vaccine development, the promotion of medical home models of care, increasing immunization of children, and encouraging entry into untapped markets, among others. But before we talk about the tools healthcare leaders can utilize to reduce vaccine underuse, we first have to talk about the size and scope of this very real healthcare issue. Vaccine underuse is a cross-cutting issue that affects all segments of the population. Children are especially vulnerable, as it's been estimated up to 25% of children lack full protection against vaccine-preventable communicable diseases. Despite this concerning statistic, a recent study found that more than 1 in 10 parents uses a vaccination schedule for their children other than the U.S. recommended immunization schedule, which results in delaying some shots and refusing others altogether. Furthermore, coverage levels for adolescents and adults are well below the Healthy People 2010 targets, and 36,000 deaths annually occur in the elderly due to flu or its complications. The underuse of vaccines costs the healthcare system significant amounts of money, perhaps $10 billion a year in direct healthcare costs and another $43 billion a year in indirect costs. The causes of vaccine underuse are complex and systemic, resulting from shortages, exemptions from vaccine requirements, provider financing issues, and health disparities. Shortages occur due to interruptions in production, supply, and the time lag between initial development and production. Exemptions from school immunization requirements are often easily obtained, and inadequate reimbursement for administering vaccines to children can be cost prohibitive for many physician practices. In addition, newer vaccines, which have been increasing in recent years, are substantially more expensive than traditional vaccines, and increased concern regarding the supposed link between vaccines and autism, despite many studies refuting a relationship, has led some parents to refuse vaccinations. Finally, income, race, and age all have an impact on the use of vaccines. Childhood poverty is a major risk factor for underimmunization. Immunization rates for Hispanics and blacks are significantly lower for those of whites, and adolescents and adults have lower vaccination rates than children. Reducing vaccine underuse requires building a coordinated set of proven practices in the field, coupled with policy actions in the private and public sectors. The following slides talk a bit more about how these proven practices and policy actions can help address this issue. Firms in the U.S. and abroad are experimenting with alternative production technologies to reduce the lead time and dependence on egg-based production of vaccines, all of which could help decrease vaccine shortages. The medical home model has demonstrated great promise in improving care coordination and continuity of care among many populations. They've also shown success in improving vaccination rates. Children in states with higher numbers of medical home practice models receive childhood vaccinations at a higher rate than those in states without so many of the medical home model practices. Community approaches that emphasize education and outreach to providers have also been shown to improve vaccination coverage in children. Furthermore, experts have recommended that public policy should be adopted which ensure adequate vaccine supply and financing, among other objectives. Although it may seem like a no-brainer, getting the support of medical leaders to educate staff and patients about the appropriate use of vaccines and having them work in partnership to educate policymakers on the appropriate use of exemptions from immunizations are both critical issues to address in vaccination underuse. As mentioned earlier, new vaccines have been increasing of late. As a result, a promising policy action for reducing vaccine underuse is to provide financial incentives which accelerate the development and approval of these new vaccines, such as those to prevent dengue fever, AIDS, SARS, and other conditions. Given the issue of inadequate reimbursement for healthcare providers for administering vaccines, it's clear that funding models must be revised to get providers more on board on addressing the issue. One way is to encourage practices that increase the number of vaccinations by linking payment reimbursements to vaccine administration and timely immunization. Finally, vaccine registries and information technologies have demonstrated success in identifying vaccine underuse. Further support of these approaches could help to improve appropriate administration of vaccines across the board. That brings us to the end of this Bend the Curve webcast. We hope that the webcast has been enjoyable and informative. If you'd like a copy of this presentation in PowerPoint form, or you'd like to learn more about this or any of the other Bend the Curve topics, please visit the website at www.nehi.net/bendthecurve. On the website, you'll find the Healthcare Leader's Guide to High-Value Healthcare, policy briefs, PowerPoint presentations, and more of these webcasts. We encourage you to use these tools to educate your colleagues, as well as to identify and implement successful solutions aimed at addressing the very real problem of healthcare waste in your organizations and communities. Thank you, and take care.